I have great pleasure in welcoming you to this landmark ceremony of inauguration of the company's largest water-based paint plant at Hindupur in the Anantapur district of Andhra Pradesh. At the outset, I would like to thank Shri N. Kiran Kumar Reddy for kindly agreeing to inaugurate the factory and making some time for us in the midst of his busy schedule. Without his personal support and active assistance of everyone concerned in the government of Andhra Pradesh, Hindupur factory would not have been possible. It is a momentous occasion for all of us at Berger Paints India Limited. You will be aware that Berger Paints India Limited is the second largest paint company in India, one of the top in Asia, and among the top 30 in the world. It is also one of the fastest growing. Our operations are spread throughout the country with 10 manufacturing facilities in India, more than 135 depots, and several regional and area offices. We have over 2,800 employees and a countrywide distribution network of 16,500 plus dealers. We have presence in all areas of the paint industry, including decorative, industrial, automotive, protective coatings, and coil coatings. Livelihood of lakhs of Indians is dependent on our operations. The Berger India Group also operates in Nepal, Bangladesh, Poland, and Russia. We have pioneered many special formulations for wall coatings and are widely known for our brands such as Silk, Weathercoat All Guard, Breathe Easy, and Easy Clean. Quarter after quarter, we have posted either the highest or the second highest growth in the country and are recognized by global investors as one of the most efficient paint producers. The demand for water-based decorative paints, which is an environmentally benign and aesthetically superior option, has been very high in the recent past. Its growth has been spectacular, particularly in southern part of India. Our teams visited all the state headquarters, and there is no doubt that we received the most positive response from the state of Andhra Pradesh. The advantages of Hindupur's location was also there. It is centrally situated with easy access to southern and western markets where we need to supply in large quantities at short notice. The Hindupur factory has an initial capacity of 80,000 tons per annum. The capacity will be upscaled to 160,000 tons per annum at a minimum cost. At the final phase, it will have a capacity of 320,000 tons per annum. Plus, there will be a plant for manufacture of 100,000 kiloliters of emulsions, for which a provision is already existing. Side by side, inspired by this factory, Berger India Group is opening a plastic packaging factory on the other side of the road. Another factory is coming up in Golapuram industrial area, just 3 to 4 kilometers from this site, for manufacture of 40,000 tons of paint. I'm also very happy to mention here that Berger has a joint venture with NBC of Japan, one of the world leaders in the field of coatings on plastic parts of cars. Our joint venture is called B&B Coatings Limited. Our JV was looking for a facility in South India for processing of its paints, and we are happy that our JV has chosen Berger's facility at Golapuram. That unit will also become operational very soon. Total investment in the Hindupur area by the Berger India Group will be close to 550 crores. Berger Hindupur will absorb a large number of engineers and other technical professionals and provide business opportunities to local vendors and ancillaries. We have engaged employees under the Rajiv Yuva Kiranalu program. There will be hundreds of trucks and containers coming in and going out every day. Many suppliers have shown interest in putting up factories in the vicinity. I'm sure that given the right kind of infrastructure, many other industries will follow suit. Arrangements have been kindly made by the government of Andhra Pradesh for providing electricity through the 33 kV line and water from the PABR water project. I hope that the government will continue to support this path-breaking effort in this backward region of Anantapur district by providing uninterrupted supply of water and electricity. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to take the opportunity to once again personally thank Shri N. Kiran Kumar Reddy, Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, for his guidance and support. I would also like to extend my sincere thanks to Dr. J. Geetha Reddy, Honorable Minister for Major Industries, Sugar, Commerce and Export Promotion, Dr. N. Raghuvira Reddy, Honorable Minister for Revenue, Disaster Management, Rehabilitation and Urban Land Sealing, Dr. Sailaj Nath, Honorable Minister for Primary Education, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Shri B. Abdul Ghani, MLA, Hindupur, and Shri J.C. Divakar Reddy, MLA and former Minister Panchayat Raj. We have been offered best of support by government officers at all levels, and I express my sincere gratitude to Shri Pradeep Chandra, Principal Secretary, Industries and Commerce Department, Dr. Rajat Kumar, Commissioner of Industries, Shri Jayesh Ranjan, Vice Chairman and Managing Director, APIIC, and Shri Lokesh Kumar DS, District Collector and Magistrate, Anantapuram, and all the past and present officers in all government departments who have assisted us. Ladies deserve special mention, and I may express my sincere thanks to Mrs. AAL Padmavati, Deputy Director, Commissioner of Industries, for all her guidance and cooperation all along. Before ending, may I express my sincere gratitude to all the suppliers, consultants and contractors, including Shapurji, Palunji and Company, and E.V. Lokhanwada and Associates, who have made this project possible.